Well, beach soccer is very different to the outdoor version of the game, which is obviously played on grass. But here on the sand, you need a very different set of skills. I've got the Beach Socceroos behind me, so let's have a look at some of the skills required to play beach soccer. The most crucial parts of beach soccer is, how do you pass on the sand? The sand is very uneven, so you have to be able to judge when to pass it or when to flick it. If it's on top of the sand like that, you can basically pass it like you normally do on grass. But if it's in a crevice like that, then you maybe have to flick it out back on top or just flick it to a player as well. One very important skill on the sand is scooping the ball up so you can flick it to another player. Now, how to do it is, once it's on the sand, what you've got to do is you've got to try and push the ball into the sand and get your foot underneath it. Once you do that, you try and scoop it up and then obviously pass it to another player. So we've just seen how the scoop is important to get it off the sand to pass it, but it's just as crucial that you get it off the sand when you're shooting. Actually, it's one of the most important skills in the game. Now, the next drill is the penalty kick. Anytime there's a free kick anywhere on the pitch, it's a free shot at goal. Now, to take it, you have to firstly make a mound. When you make a mound with the ball, you do a circle and you put it on top of the mound. Now, you can't touch the sand with your hands at all. If you do, it's a free kick to the other team. Once you've done that and you've set it, you've got 6 seconds to take the shot. So you clear a bit of a path and then you take the shot. But I think the best person to show you how it's done is our coach, Anton Andreoli. Well, one of the most exciting, but also one of the most difficult skills is the bicycle kick. It's something beach soccer is known for. Let's have a look.